There are four simple steps to getting Fastpass locally in your system. Mileage may vary based on your needs, but I'll show you the quickest path to offering a single sign-on using a sample PHP application. Here are the four steps. Add the Fastpass library to your application. Reference the library if you're within your app. Embed a script method that will encapsulate your user credentials. Configure your external login URL. Now let's install Fastpass. In this example, I've already set up my community to use the domain alias. Make sure you do this first too if you're going to use a full name. In your admin area, there's a section for Fastpass if you've upgraded to a plan that includes it. This is ground zero for Fastpass setup. I'm using PHP, so I'm going to download the PHP library. This is a folder which I'm going to rename Fastpass and then place it into an appropriate directory within my application. That's it for step one. In order to use the library within our app, we need to link to it. For this example, I'm going to link it in the same file where I plan on invoking the script method, right here in the footer template. We're referencing fastpass.php inside the fastpass directory I just added. Done. This is the most complicated step, the heart of the integration. We're going to call a method that writes special JavaScript where it can be invoked after a user logs in. Be sure to consider the various login paths within your site when selecting the best place to add the script. I'm putting mine in a set folder, so it will be sure to get called no matter which entry point the user comes into. The simplest thing to do is copy the sample call from the Fastpass admin page. It comes populated with your account information in the domain area setting. But if you want it to work for all your users, you'll need to replace the variables as follows. The first variable has the Fastpass key. Don't touch that. The second variable is the Fastpass secret, which along with the key is how GetSatisfaction knows to trust your site to authenticate users. Leave that as it is. The next three variables are the user's email address, name, and the system's unique ID for them. We need to dynamically populate each of these. First, I paste the sample code into the footer template. I add an HTML comment around the code for easy debugging. The Fastpass script method returns the value, but it doesn't print it, so I explicitly output the value into a template with an echo. Next, I add the dynamic values, email, username, unique ID. Save. Now, after a user logs in, the script tag is invoked, setting a cookie with the user's credentials. If you click over to the community, their information comes along with them. The final step is to configure the external login URL. This is the web page where I want my users to log in if they come to GetSatisfaction first. I enter my URL. When a user visits the community and takes some action that requires a login, they're prompted to log in at the URL I just added. This creates a uniform experience no matter where the end user begins their journey. And there you have it, the four steps to setting up Fastpass. That wasn't so painful now, was it?